All right, we're going to continue the story where we left off in the last chapter. And that, of course, you know, we're on to the Bane boss fight. Yep, we're just sticking with the main story. We're not going to really do any of the side missions this time. Maybe for another video, but for now we're going to be focusing on this. I tell you, even compared to The Dark Knight Rises, probably just as realistic of a Bane compared to, like, any of them. I mean, you know, since usually the one in the comic, you know, that has the Venom and stuff, like, obviously attached to him. Like I said, this is a more of a realistic take, kind of. Oh, man. I didn't really mean to do that, but anyway, let's go on ahead and upgrade the armor. Oh yeah, this will be an awesome one. Give us an advantage in this fight. Oh, yeah, no! Ha, I pressed Y, but I guess I wasn't on the mark. Oh man, again, not on the mark. This is like the less intense Bane boss fight compared to the one we'll encounter later. Oh man, again, not on the mark. Oh no! Okay, I hit him a few times. Alright, oh no! Oh yeah. I was about to do the combo, but I was a bit too late, I think. Oh well. Oh no, I wasn't on the mark. Who you calling boy? Come on, man, I hit Y. That time I must have been more on it. Yeah, sometimes you can never really time that right. Especially when it comes to Bane Boar's attacks are like so fast even compared to the thugs. Yeah, well right here he's starting to kind of look like how he did in the comic. Like he came out of the military or something too at the same time. See, when he's not on the Venom, he's supposed to be like 5'6" or something. Man, he already looked like a giant even before he like activated the Venom. I don't know, perhaps the Venom was already activated, eh? All right. Venom's not going to save you this time. Oh! Gosh. Again, I wasn't fast enough. Oh, yeah, well, that time I was. Feel the power of electrocutioner's shot gloves. I am so much better with them than he is. Oh, no. Now I'm in trouble. Oh crap! I wanted to. Oh shit! No! I see there is still something. Damn! Oh, man. Oh, damn. Seriously, Bane, you have these guys to assist you, so you're pretty much cheating compared to me. Oh no, he activated the venom again. Not good. Shit. Oh damn. He almost broke me again. Yeah, but I don't think I'm gonna last, though. I haven't got very much health left. Oh, man, those torps are back. Oh, crap, no. Oh, no. I guess I might as well keep my mouth shut because this is a boss battle that that requires undivided attention, I guess. Even on easy, boy, this could be a bitch. Oh, yes, I did it that time. Oh, yeah. You never cease to entertain me, Joker. Oh no! Oh fuck that. Oh no! Hey, what a bastard. You will get this, and I shall take you down. Oh, fuck you. Almost didn't even. It looked like he had just, like, maybe one hit left, but. Apprehend the Joker, more like defeat Bane. Yeah. Imbecile. Bane's about to be even more vulnerable, it looks like. Oh no, no! Oh no! Oh my gosh! Thank you. Where I'm standing, it looks pretty cold, more like it. And all that snow and it being like the beginning of winter. And consider this a draw, Bane. Slipped my mind that you had to hit the Y button there. Pretty cool how Robert Costanzo reprised Detective Bullock for this game. Yeah, but sadly Mark Hamill and Kevin Conroy couldn't voice Joker and Batman. Yeah, but this being a prequel, it actually worked out for the best. I think, yeah, you know, I mean, at least I think Roger Craig Smith did a pretty good job portraying Batman. I mean, Troy Baker's better as Two-Face, in my opinion, but I guess he does fare exceptionally well as Joker, but I think he's actually a little better as Batman, even. Because in that Batman Ninja Turtles crossover, he voiced both Batman and Joker in that. He did a little better as Batman, I must say. Harleen Quinzel. Get to play as Joker when he was Red Hood in the flashback scene.
There's nothing so cruel as memory. The pointy, biting little thunderbolts, unwanted party crashes, screaming to your synapses. Inescapable, unrelenting, not at all friendly. You can't even escape into madness. And then you meet someone who changes your life. And being, you don't even know who you are anymore. Isn't it funny how one little encounter can cleave off little pieces of your past, deform your memories and persona to rethink your whole identity? And as you realize how foolish it all is,
yep, playing as Red Hood now.
You want to know something
Need your puzzle skills for this. Well, kind of. You gotta wait until it, like, stops. Oh, yeah, you can duck through it.
I feel adrift, floating, like someone's pulled the stopper on my reality. I'm sucked down the drain into something new. It's all very exciting, really. You wouldn't know what that feels like, I'm sure.
I might. Can you tell me more about how this person makes you feel?
It's like meeting someone I can actually relate to. Which, believe me, dear, I've never felt before. You understand. You're someone who's not afraid to let go and fall. Free falling, and I didn't pack a chute. You know what I mean?
Yes. Yes, I do.
I figured you would.
So, may I ask, who is this person?
Oh, someone very, very special. But whose real name?
My name's Harleen. Harleen Quinzel.
What a pretty name. Your friends call you Harley.
I don't have a lot of friends.
Well, Harley, you got one now.
All right, now we're going back into Batman's mind here.
Sounds like this could be Bane or one of his men. If I hurry to the GCPD morgue, I can inspect the body and the autopsy report.
Well, before you leave, I run some tests on the compound you found at the steel mill. Looks like a match for your globular projectile for non-lethal restraint.
You mean the blue grenade?
Indeed. The resin has finished curing. It's at your workbench.
Okay, time to go to the workbench then. Blue grenade. Alright. Upgrade. Batsuit chamber, huh? That's available for challenge mode, and never mind. Fast travel. Oh, yes. There we go. Hitting the A button before.
Stop, Master Bruce. Bruce, I will not in good conscience allow you to go. You're outmatched by these
bastards.
You're not some hardened vigilante. You're a young man with a trust fund and too much anger. In over your head, and I don't want this to be your head.
Albert Bruce, the boy whose shoes you used to tie every morning. To his first date. What you are feeling like I am not there. The only thing to an innocent human
right.
I am. When the mother or the thief stops to think twice, that is fear. That is what I am. That is why they hire assassins, because I am the reason the criminals believe this here for the sudden innocence. So no, Alfred, I am not in over my head.
It's okay. I understand.
Oh. Thank you. glue grenade. Ah. My glue grenade. Ah, there we go. Try this on for size. Oh, yeah. All right, now we gotta find the entrance. Wherever. Oh man, there's a crime going on. Oh no! Bloody sniper. You thought I was about to pussy out, but no. Idea how much I am. And time for a good old blast of the past. We're going to play Mortal Kombat Armageddon on the OG Xbox, on the 360. Backwards compatible. Not all OG Xbox games are backwards compatible on the 360, sadly, but... this one is, luckily enough. It's too bad my original Xbox doesn't really work that well right now. I mean, it works, but I gotta clean the lens, because I think the lens is dirty since my games won't load on it right now. So peeved about it.
The critical point
Kentaro! Wait, no, that's Goro. And from that forward angle, though, I mean, it kind of looked like Kentaro at first. Just to me, at least. Apparently this, as well as the other two games, like Deadly Alliance and, you know, Deception, these are like the Mortal Kombat games that are like more like infamous compared to like all the others, even compared to MK4. Let's just skip the intro and just get right to the arcade style Mortal Kombat. Look at this huge roster of fighters. Man, no Mortal Kombat game has a roster this big. So unreal. It's incredible. Sticking with my man Raiden. Yeah, more people like Scorpion, but I'm a Raiden guy myself. Have been as long as I've been playing Mortal Kombat. Man, is this game underrated or what? Thunderhawk is next. Yeah, down with ya. Yeah, and I know tomorrow I gotta go and get my hair cut, or my hair shaped up anyway. Yeah, go to the bank and get me a little extra cash. Yeah, I've gotta roll up my change here this evening after I'm done with this video vlog. Oh yeah, down you go. Oh no! Yeah, Quan Chi is turning out to be pretty formidable here. I'm about to be taken down by the sorcerer. Oh no! Oh gosh. What reflexes? Crap. Oh, damn. No! Oh, no. Great. Ah. No! Oh, great. Oh, man. Yeah, I'll continue. I guess I'll go another round. Pick a different guy this day. I picked Sub-Zero this time. Sub-Zero is one of my other favorite characters, so... Oh, what do you know? Mirror match next. Overlooked that before. Played the reboot of Mortal Kombat 1. It actually wasn't as bad as people say. I at least liked the story of it. The story mode was better than MK11, I thought. The fact that it's a fresh start and all that, too, and puts on a new flavor on Mortal Kombat, I mean, that's just what made it so such a good game. I mean, it wasn't great or anything like that, but it's not as bad as people are, like, making it, I don't think. And, of course, 2027 will probably be the year of Mortal Kombat 2. Every 4 years, they make a new Mortal Kombat game. Just too bad there hasn't got we haven't gotten Injustice 3 yet. I don't even know if we're even going to. Man, is Quan Chi a tough cookie. No match for my Cory Blade. Mirror match coming up. I have won just that round, of course. I still haven't seen that new Deadpool and Wolverine movie, but man, I can't wait to see it, though. My mom and I will probably go see it, not this coming weekend or the weekend after. My mom's going to be busy, and we usually don't like to go opening weekend because the theater we go to, people are usually kind of obnoxious in it. They kick the seats and all that. Yeah, I think it's getting good reviews based on what the internet has been indicating. I didn't read any of them or nothing, but... generally, I don't want spoilers until the movie's at least 6 months old. Not 6 years, 6 months. Great. Love the fact that they kept the nostalgia noise in from, like, the originals. Oh, no! Tough cookie indeed. Nope, you ain't doing that. You want to use high tech, huh, Mataro? Well, you got your match here. Those literally look like lightsabers. Oh, no! Play something else. Alright, gonna play some Super Street Fighter 4. I've actually got that Street Fighter Alpha cartoon series on DVD. I got every episode. Bought it at a convention years ago.
Super Street Fighter 4 Arcade Edition.
We only got so much time on our hands, so we might as well just skip the intro.
Seeks to destroy and consume all that enters her sight. That includes me. Still, as long as I can manipulate her like a pawn in my grand game, I shall leave her to her own devices. She has altered her own body in her insatiable quest for power. She respects no law, no morality. She does whatever it takes to achieve her goals and quench her limitless thirst.
What an intro for a storyline of a game for a character in a fighting one.
Whether they admit it or not. Strip away the restrictions of law and common decency, and it becomes clear that the engine that drives humanity is their own selfish ambition. To achieve one's own goals necessitates trampling those of others underfoot. Yet mankind is all too anxious to label those who would do so as What a tragic irony. Humanity's defeat at my hands will serve to strengthen me. I will be baptized in the fire of their unabashed ambition and be born anew, ready to usher in a new age, free from the restrictions of artificial morality. I can then hunt down this emotionless animal for sport and put her down for good.
Got Rose as our first opponent here. I guess it's not really a bad thing. Yeah, Seth looks like an evil version of Dr. Manhattan from The Watchmen. Speaking of Watchmen, they have a upcoming new movie, animated movie, coming out. It's kind of like the live-action movie. The animation's supposed to be influenced off the comic as well.
Are you ready?
Years ago, I had that Watchmen game on the 360. I think I sold it for whatever reason. It actually wasn't that bad of a game from what I remember, though. At the same time, Seth is very similar to Perfect Cell from Dragon Ball Z. He, like, has all the moves of the finest fighters in the Street Fighter verse, kind of the same way how Cell had all the special moves of all the greatest Z warriors, and even Frieza himself, who was the greatest villain. Yeah, because when Frieza and King Cole, when they landed on Earth, you know, they were able to put more cells together to make the ultimate fighting machine.
Yeah.
Another round one.
So there was value in observing you after all.
Pick up the pace. Fight!
Show you better. Why don't you take this for the next one?
Oh, down you go right then and there. Nothing bores me quite like the power of the flawed human psyche. Oh, what do you know? I dodged a bullet. Next level, yeah.
Pick up the pace!
Now we gotta fight Zangief. Yeah, even he's no match for Seth. I can't believe Seth Rollins is gonna be in the next Captain America movie that's gonna have feature Red Hulk in it, man. I didn't even believe that when I heard the rumors or like the. But apparently, according to Wiki and Seth Rollins himself, he's confirmed that that's true, though. It's like, man, what is it with WWE superstars always getting casted in Hollywood media? I mean, even Sasha Banks, now Mercedes over in AEW, she was in the Mandalorian Season 2. It's like, man, can't Hollywood just leave those superstars alone? They got enough stuff on their plate. Aw, man. Perhaps I spoke too soon earlier. No! Oh, come on! Doing that. I still haven't played Street Fighter VI. I don't know. I've been hearing that it's like better than 5, but not better than this one, though. Crap!
So there was value in observing you after all.
That was a close shave, though. That could have went either way. I'd be happening to continue or something, game over. The Zangief.
You lose. The curtain is raised on the world's most extreme fighting tournament. Who will walk away victorious?
You second fighting style.
Yeah.
Yeah, let's play something else. Yeah, we are going to play Star Wars The Force Unleashed, one of the best Star Wars games of all time right here. And we'll just override a slot. Yeah, I guess where I'm old, we'll just play on Apprentice, because still kind of maybe is a little rusty for I ain't played in a little bit. But yeah, this is like the first Star Wars thing that Sam Witwer, the voice of Darth Maul in Clone Wars and Rebels and a lot of those animations, you know, this is like the first Star Wars thing he ever did. Also voicing the main protagonist of the game, or villain protagonist, anti-hero, whatever you want to call him. Starkiller, Galen Merrick. Probably what he's slightly more known for over Darth Maul. I don't think we're going to play the whole game here, because don't forget, this is mainly just a little bit of an extension from where, you know, when I played Arkham Origins, you know, I mean, we didn't really go that far into it and stuff, so. Gosh, it's been a hot summer all summer, pretty much. Even with rain, it can still be pretty damn hot. Oh. Is Darth Vader. To many, this was probably an awesome thing, because you know how much of a fan base Darth Vader has, and you get to play him at the start of this game. Okay, let's get this show on the road. Thank you. Okay, let's be off. I don't know why the sound went out there for a minute, but it could be the HD plug on my 360 on this smart TV I'm playing on. Down you go, Wookiee. Ha 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 ha. The other day at the flea market, you know, I bought the special editions of Star Wars, the 97 versions. You know, they're slightly different than the old 4 versions. Although, of course, you know, I always kind of preferred Han shot first, but boy, in the Greedo shot first version, in the 97 version, it's like, you know, Han says, I'll bet you have, and, you know, it leads to that, while, of course, you know, the 04 version, it's kind of like a blend of the original and the 97. Because there were, like, a few things that were, like, taken out of the 97 versions of the 04 version, where it kind of made it seem a little bit more like the originals at the same time. The same could sort of be said for the 2011 versions on Blu-ray. The ones that I also have. And, you know, even, like, before Vader throws the Emperor down that shaft, he even does no, like, from Revenge of the Sith. Thank you. Tom Kane, the voice of Yoda from Clone Wars, voicing that guy. You don't know the power of the dark side, Rogue Jedi. Oh. Well, I'll admit, you know, I mean, Darth Vader really ain't that good of a Sith when you get right down to it. I mean, you know, he turned to the dark side simply because of fear. It's like, you know, he wanted to protect, though. He turned it to protect people and all that. You know, being a Sith ain't really about that, really. It's about gaining power and, you know, rage and all that. I mean, even Darth Maul knew how to be a Sith way more than Vader did. I'll admit, Darth Maul's kind of become a favorite of mine since I watched him in Clone Wars. I binge-watched the Clone Wars, and Darth Maul had a pretty damn good arc in the show. He was pretty good at Rebels, too, especially where he took down a whole army of Grand Inquisitors. Mini game time. That was another cool thing about the Xbox 360 era. You know, these little mini games in the games. It's too bad we don't get them like this anymore as much. I would have to say to this day, the Xbox 360 is, probably always will be, the best of the Xboxes. The Xbox One was a bit dull. The Xbox Series X and S is good, but I hate all the updates it has to do. I haven't even played my Series S in a while. Or at least haven't connected it to the internet in a while. Now Darth Vader has a secret apprentice. This no longer counts as canon, though. This is a Legends Expanded Universe. That's the kind of Star Wars I like better, you know. I don't really care much for canon, except for the stuff with Grand Admiral Thrawn and Darth Maul. You know, some of Rebels was pretty good. Ahsoka was pretty decent, too. I even watched some of Tales of the Empire, like the episode that had Grand Admiral Thrawn, Rook, and Captain Pallian. Your training is nearly complete. It is time to face your first true test. The spies have located Jedha. Yes, Master Ron Kota. He is attacking a critical Imperial shipyard. Destroy him. Bring me his lightsaber. I shall leave at once, Master. The Emperor. I was really disappointed on the port of this game on the Switch. Anybody who hasn't played this on the Switch, I would advise them not to buy it, or just save your money and don't even buy it. I mean, on the Nintendo Switch, this game was shit. I mean, it didn't even really look all that good either. I mean, it looked like a regular DS game compared to even this here on the 360. Proxy, the droid, who's a master of disguise. Combat training program in years. I thought you'd erased it. I hoped that using an older training module would catch you off guard and allow me to finally kill you. I'm sorry I failed you again. I'm sure you'll keep trying. But do me a favor. Don't ambush me. Proxy, yes. Yes.
Accessing Imperial records. Captain Juno Eclipse,
You don't see too many blonde chicks in the Star Wars universe. Right there you're looking at one, and a sweet one at that. Juno Eclipse. Sure is cool having an Imperial captain on your side.
Let's hope so. I'm sick of training new pilots. What have you done to my ship?
Yeah, handpicked by Darth Vader, and, you know, she shares his secret. Yeah, and at the same time, the Emperor even has a secret hand, so... That's Mara Jade. At least in Expanded Universe, he had her. She isn't canon again yet, but there's been talks about her possibly becoming canon, as well as Prince Xizor from Shadows of the Empire. I tell you, Star Wars Expanded Universe was one of the coolest things out there, and now it's been renamed to Legends. It's cool to know that they still make reprints of the books and stuff. Yeah, but Disney can only keep so much of that stuff.
Welcome aboard the road.
They knew what they were getting into when they bought it. Something tells me if it weren't for Dave Filoni, I don't even think any of that stuff would even be around whatsoever. Sure, it's good to know that Dave Filoni still decided to stick around. It was kind of him that saved the franchise. For like a lot of us who were fans of the Expanded Universe.
Prove your mastery of grip by using the object to smash through these three glass panels.
I can imagine Jon Favreau probably is a fan of the Expanded Universe and stuff, too.
Excellent, Master. You can also use grip to pick up and now demonstrate your newfound power by gripping and throwing these objects to knock over the three frightened stormtroopers standing in front.
Okay, now we are about to start the first mission.
According to Imperial records, Master Ron Coder was respected general in the Clone Wars. Master Coder was a military genius, but felt the clone soldiers were unfit for battle. Instead, he relied on his own militia.
So, there were no clones in his squadron in Order 66, Mr. Chief?
After Order 66, he vanished. Official Imperial records actually claim he's dead.
Why's another
fighter
attack the Empire now?
He wants to be found.
Then we're walking into a trap. How many pilots have you lost before me?
Seven.
Excellent. Ordnance for Nar Shaddai are locked. Prepare for lightspeed.
Lock down the command center and get that hologram projector up and running.
Yes, sir. Yeah, Ron Coda uses a green saber, unlike Obi-Wan, who used blue.
Explosive charge.
The overall biggest flaw this game had is that it was probably a little too short, but man, if you think that of this one, you ought to play The Force Unleashed 2, man. You could probably play and beat that game maybe in about 3 hours, if that. Imagine if you like did a speed run of this one, you could probably even have this one. There should be no survivors, even droids. You heard the Master Vader, so gotta get rid of the droids, too. What is going on? Come on, give me that grip. Down you guys go.
Eclipse to Starkiller. I've intercepted a message from the flight tower. The Imperials have mobilized a TIE fighter squadron in your sector. Keep your eyes open.
Okay, we need to find, we need to further go on. I know we don't go back there, we go this way. Oh, yeah.
Level up!
Whoa, whoa, whoa. I meant to... There we go. Yep, you earn force points here. It's all of a sudden raining in my turf. And I didn't even think it was supposed to rain today. I thought it was supposed to be sunny, but it wasn't going to rain again tomorrow. But oh no, the game glitched on me, didn't it? Ah. Figures. Now, this game does that a lot on this 360 of mine. But anyway, since it's kind of raining and stuff anyway, I might not even have time because it might even thunderstorm or something in a bit. But anyway, I guess this will probably just do it for this chapter of Batman Arkham Origins Chapter 5. Yeah, if I said Chapter 4 earlier, I meant 5. But, yeah. And, anyway, I guess, but yeah, I added a little bit just to kind of make this a little bit longer of a vlog because it kind of felt too short with what I played of it. But anyway, I will be back with more later.